Did you enlist or were you drafted? And
I was drafted. Took my physical when I was on my 19th birthday. I was in at Minneapolis taking my physical, and then a month later, of course, I went into service and took my. Ended up down in Texas at what is now Fort Hood. Took my training down there. It's basically infantry, and came home on furlough and went. Back to reported in at an organ, whatever, I don't remember the name of the and anyhow, near as I can remember, apparently the bomb was dropped while possibly I was on the train going out. I don't know. I know when we got out there, we were supposed to have a week before we shipped out, and they give us a week's leave, so we had actually 2 weeks. And then I shipped out of the Seattle port the 2nd of September in 45, the day they was signing the declaration in Tokyo Bay, the surrender in Tokyo Bay. I was shipping out of Seattle, so I missed the war that close. So,
how did it feel to know that you missed it, though?
I was quite pleased, very happy, yeah. So then I went, they shipped down to Philippines. I was in a engineering depot down there for several months, and then I volunteered for an administrative school and for a month in Manila, and went from there to Tokyo to part of MacArthur's headquarters. We was in administration. We did all the administration work for the 5,000 men in his headquarters. So that was basically my career as such. So
tell me about the time before you left for training. Were you living in Washington at that time?
Yes, I graduated from school the spring before, of course, and just farmed with my dad. Helped my dad on the farm until that time, and so then I went from there.
Tell me about your life, you know, at home during World War II. What was it like during that time?
I don't recall a lot of restrictions. Of course, I realized gas was restricted, or coupons, and sugar. My dad had a great craving for sugar, and this was always a thing that mother tried to come up with extra sugar, what have you. And that was one of the more main things that was noticeable for our family. So, basically we got along pretty good up until that. And after I went in service, and some of my younger cousins that lived in town came out and helped Dad farm in harvest time and this type of thing.
Did you have any other family that went into the war?
No, I didn't. I had an older brother that lived in Minnesota that was farming and working for other people farming, and he never he took a physical, but he didn't go in. And my dad had been in World War I, and when I got put in 1A, my mother wanted to know if I wanted to stay out. She thought one of the neighbors I could work for them and I could stay, and I thought, well, I'll just go with it. And so I went in with service. So.
Did you have a lot of friends that went in with you?
They developed into friends. There was a lot of people. There was a whole train load of us went from Beadle County, took that. Several acquaintances and several I got acquainted with from the other towns, Wolsey and Tiern and what have you, that remained friends for the rest of their life, shall we say. And so there was quite a, there's, I don't know, I think there was 30 some of us. There was a car load of them, anyhow.
How long were you in the Philippines then?
I think it was just shortly less than 2 years, 21 months. I got out the 1st of December in 46, and so it was just a couple months less.
You came back to farm then?
Yeah, I came back to farm and farmed for about four years, I guess it was. And then I ended up getting married and going out to California for a while, and then came back here. It was nice out there, but it's always nice, so that's, you get tiresome. So, gotta have some South Dakota wind once in a while.
Right. You just can't live without that wind,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, that's right.
So, well, is there anything else you'd like to share, or experiences that you had?
It was a great learning experience, and I just enjoyed, maybe I didn't enjoy it at the time, but seeing the world and the way some other people live, not necessarily at the Army situation, but it's a great learning experience. So I've always been glad that I went.